they're trying to do whatever they can to use it, to encourage people to use it. And one of them was to make charcoal with it. And can I just turn that on? Oh! Yeah, this is a tool.
This is a tool, look at that.
Oh, yeah. It was good to have the right tools.
So, actually, what is the best thing to do is actually burn it from the top. That's what they recommend, because then you have a smokeless fire. So all the smoke has to go through the flame, and that's the best way to do it. But this has actually got a lot of other grass and stuff.
Yeah, there's a lot of kindling light stuff.
Oh boy, is that gonna go off? They wanted to do charcoal with it to control it, and they found it at 130 Celsius granotoxin, which is the toxin that is a nerve toxin, makes you drool.
Mm-hmm. Makes the goats and the sheep die.
Yeah. Mm. And you know, mostly they die from pneumonia because they start drooling. And it goes back down into their lungs. And then all the carbon's gonna fall. Oh, did I not bring the fork?
Oh, it's
against my tractor. It's by my tractor. So I'll put my little hand.
Here, we might want to move that far, you know.
Anyways, at 130 degrees Celsius, which is before even smoking, the granotoxin gets driven off.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
So it's perfect for biochar.
Well, oh, it's kind of windy. All that ash that you can do. I actually might need to use my finger. It's all that grass. I just take the whole row and just grab it all up, put it in a pile, and char it right there. And it chars much better than this stuff because this is solid. Bamboo is not solid, so it chars so perfect because it's just that thin layer which is almost the same thickness as their branches. When you have different size thicknesses, you're not going to get sort of a even charcoal. If I lit the charcoal back on fire or heated it up, it would burn to ash. But I don't do that, and I put it into my soil. So and now it's my soil.
So you're going for
and
really
I'm cleaning
hot.
Up the place too. That's what I like about it.
Yeah.
Cleaning up the place a little.
You're going for really hot and to burn off a lot of the wood gas, but then you're saving the carbon.
Yeah, it's all falling. It's all falling on the bottom right now. I have an excavator with a thumb on it, and I do like it's got bamboo grove there. I'll be like moving it all around with those things.
That large bamboo that you grow down here.
Yeah.
Where do you get a start of that? What's the name of it?
Oh, I can't. I just wouldn't have the what do you call it? I wouldn't feel right about giving that to someone. It will grow from here all the way to the other side of that building in one year.
Yeah.
Like one
season.
Yeah, it will. One that is really not good to have around. But that's around. That one there, I got out of Valerie's garden. Somebody planted it in her garden, and I said, Valerie, you have got to get rid of that immediately.
And you took it.
I took it, and I planted it. But you really need to know if it's okay where you're going to plant it, because it could really cause you.
Well, do you come out to people's home sites and tell them where they should and should not plant?
I haven't, and I guess I could.
I mean, Brandon does that, and Brandon's pretty connected to Leon. Maybe he could convince him.
To help. You don't feel comfortable watching somebody else work. I know. I just got off work this morning, so I'm okay. I'm all right with it. For now, today.
Get it all in there.
There we go.
All burned up.
Should clear.
I
want to ash it. Some stuff is going to be gone.
Like, how long it'll take? How did you know the right time?
And another way to keep it cool.
To stop it from burning so that it doesn't go into ash. I have no idea. How do you know which ones?
And around the edges, the earth's coming in.
Faster than the other. And he he said he picks
where
he burns most of
the
bamboo.
I have big.
I was thinking that. I just.
Leon, how do you know when to put it out? How do you know when it's been enough?
Oh, you'll know.
Like when I make my homemade cookies,
I
know.
All the stuff.
I can't tell you how to do it.
You don't know how to make homemade puddings?
Oh my god.
Fire's.
Oh, you know when the fire's done? Yeah. I just, my mom would say, okay.
Yeah. Chili probably with
the
fire. When you don't
then the pudding.
See much of it.
Bamboo works.
And it's
so
already
much.
Like.
Yeah, with your fans,
like,
yeah, bamboo works
like,
better.
Like red?
Which is great.
Right.
You have the end of
in his hydraulic tractor. And take it where he needs it. We're going to have to get a tractor.
I can see your wheels.
It is. We're trying to.
Get your shopping list.
Yeah. Well, he's got the list. He's the one who says, okay, this is first. This is what we can do. This is what we can't do this year. Every year we have a plan. He has a plan.
I see all the stone on the line. I don't know what you want to understand.
But then he saw the
lot of
tires
years
and stuff.
Where do y'all live again?
In McDowell County. Behind off of 70, we live off of 70 going out of there into old.
Well,
I know people buying land out there.
They're welding. Yeah, I have a pair. Yeah.
Oh, a lot cheaper.
They're great around the campfire.
We were so lucky.
Yeah, we got a nice
actually,
little.
Actually,
take
my idea
why
he does this with the horse.
Like
ah.
Yeah.
A lot of it's forest though.
That's
it's
okay.
Grown, it used to be like for cattle and it grew up and it's still got all the barbed wire fencing in it and threw it in around
we
it.
We go from about 1,200 to 1,500.
Yeah.
We got some spots where you can just look at this.
Oh,
it's
beautiful.
Really?
Mount Mitchell, it's like, look, yeah, it's amazing. It really is pretty. It's just hilly
but
like this.
It
yeah.
needs a lot of work.
It does.
Water.
We have watered.
The mountain comes down
busy.
The road.
40 acres will keep you
busy. We only have how many
here,
though?
I think 35 woods and probably will stay that way.
I don't know. We don't want to
find a few minutes.
The bottom half.
So I say no. I'm saying.
A little
on the
horses.
Well, that costs money, as Andrew says. Horses have to have feed. And if you don't, you can't grow your food to feed them, then that's going to cost money and take it out of the budget.
No,
so we don't have horses. Yeah, they tear it, and that's
okay. Yeah, but
they're
horses, so it's okay.
I know. He said, are you going to eat that horse if you have to? That's what he said.
No.
So, okay. It's you or
the horse.
We would eat the horse.
See?
In the zombie apocalypse, you probably eat
yeah.
the horse.
Yeah.
They have all that great fertilizer.
Yeah.
A horse makes a lot
and
of fertilizer.
Yes, they do. We had
or we have charcoal.
Or a
rye.
Plant-based fertilizer, yeah. Well, it's cleared tiered all the way back to the that one that it cuts down by the way.
Oh,
ooh, poke your eye out. And does everybody join in to help do stuff? You said you know something about hauling all the.
I think he said he does a lot.
Yeah.
He did for the hunt. Yeah. This is his
He's had some folks that have been working here. There's a one guy that worked in the garden for a number of years. But mostly he's on his own.
Yeah. This is
the farm that you all saw with Christine, and that's much more cooperative. There's lots of people milking.
Oh.
She's running it more cooperatively.
It's better that way because you
don't know. Well, there's pros and cons.
Right.
When you work on your own, you don't have to negotiate or argue with anyone.
Mm-hmm.
You do your thing. And when you're doing cooperative, it's a whole lot more communication and negotiation, but you have more help. So it's your personality, you know?
It's true.
He's just such a doer.
He's a loner. Him and the dogs. Yeah.
Well, you know, if you're like this, you know, you're just every single day gets so much better.
Right.
Nobody's bothering you.
Right. Nobody's bothering you.
Yeah.
That's later for you, and this would be me. I would have to be because he works like crazy hours, and I'm free through the week, and then he's on the weekend.
Yeah, I'm not used to
that. So that would
there
be, yeah, we'd have to trade it off. And he does a lot of weekends. I love that bamboo. That's amazing. It is amazing. And he'd mention that. I mean, look at the way he's like, I think we should go with some bamboo.
It seems like nobody plants it where we live, but it still grows.
Still there.
Yeah.
I think my grandmother had it. And I don't know why she had it, but she had it down like he did by the stream.
Uh-huh.
She had it, you know, there growing. Which was, now that I saw his, I was like, wow.
Yeah, that was a really neat space with the bamboo.
It really is.
Yeah, it is a neat space. Yeah. And yeah, he said he got mushroom towel. Yeah.
How often does he flush? I
can't remember.
And then he does soaking when it's dry.
That to make.
Yeah. He soaks all those by hand. That's just tedious. Yeah. We'll do whatever at number of stacks.
He's still got strong and good juice.
I mean, once the mushrooms get on in there, those lobs are light.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was going to say,
the lobs. No, that's, I help him.
I don't know enough about it, so I want to research more about it, but that's a good crop to have. Like,
yes, when they're
brand new. I know you don't like mushrooms.
Well, I'm not opposed
to
selling
them every day. She's not opposed to selling them. I love them. But,
just send me the card where you
but
have them.
The other mushrooms that you can grow that are really not for edible and more medicinal.
Mushrooms and turmeric. Over at the shed. He has mushrooms and turmeric.
Yeah, I know one buys some turmeric.
Yeah.
I didn't saw the email, but that was today. We're coming from Charlotte, so we just really like, we have to get back anyway.
I forgot to end cash. Katie, people didn't know about the potluck, so a lot of people didn't bring it because it wasn't in the email.
Yeah, it was. It was.
But it was like
not put in the email.
Maybe. Yeah,
I don't know.
It was.
I thought I did.
I saw it. But I sent the email today. Was it in the previous email?
Yeah.
So
the address on the
top. Oh, what? I probably just, then it's my fault.
No, don't feel bad.
I did an employee read. I just read the top.
Yeah.
I got the confirmation.
This is good feedback. Tell me this feedback. Do you think
it in big, bold letters?
Maybe in the subject.
Or maybe people don't want it. Maybe
they
just
want
to come to
me.
You do?
No.
I mean, part of it was like...
Yeah, I would
pay to
go, but I...
Yeah. That would be awesome.
That's fine.
Yeah.
It was.
I would still do it if I didn't.
Coconut.
And I didn't read the email. So.
I didn't read the confirmation.
I should
sorry
have.
Today.
I should have.
Coconut
okay. I will for now.
No, don't worry about it. This is a learning process for me, too. So we'll hang out with
coconut.
You.
Coconut. The whole shell. They call that
the husk.
Yeah, but they use it for peat moss. Core. Coconut core.
I love homemade puddings. Homemade banana puddings.
Pineapple
puddings.
I
didn't know. Not yet. Slowly, we will. Probably for the Sunday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything's
going to
be
We're kind of starting on a high note here.
No, I think
it'll
be good. That's a lot of people. But maybe people have much smaller projects
and
smaller homesteads.
But it's a very
realistic
project.
Maybe
people
have
smaller projects. Right? You know, maybe this is not something that somebody can do. This would be the luck, but they would like something to be maybe half.
Like he said, 20 year, you know, we're
right. Progress.
You can't just turn this on tomorrow.
No, this takes time.
Yeah,
with the whole
I think in July, Chris Smith is going to show us his place, and he's on Lustin and Winter.
Okay.
In
see that? I was reading
and
that.
And his wife did their whole homestead project in under a year, just in their spare time.
One acre.
That's something that people might be interested in as well, because
Not
everybody can do that. So I think you got to have various degrees of homesteading.
Totally. Everything's going to be unique depending on what your lifestyle is.
Yeah. And I think the 20 years versus started it last year is a big difference that you need to be able to see as well.
Because this is exciting about all those projects, but it's like, oh my God, you start hearing about all the years in it, and you're like, oh, okay, so.
Well, it could become that, which is cool to see what the
outcome. But then when you see the reality of, okay, this is where you start, and then from there you know that you can get here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's something that your daughter would be able to.
Especially for us, we have different, I mean, completely different. Mm-hmm. And the more we go out and we get to these experiences, I start molding my. I'm not going to be doing that. You can do that with the. Yeah. And that's where we're now.
We're going to build this.
And I'm like, I want a house that I can live in. I'm not going to spend the next 10 years building.
Right. You're more comfortable saying what you want.
So,
break it down by project. But you think in Portland, the first thing, let's build a house. And then we can,
Give me a house so I can start working on the garden.
Yes, exactly. That's what I'm doing. Maybe have maybe two or three chickens.
You could put a trailer on the land, start a garden, and build a house.
Yeah, right.
That's what they want. But I've been.
We have a fifth wheel, so it will be your own trailer. The building thing, and then onto the property when we
And if we're going to be working, or he's the one that's going to be building, but he's going to be working, I'm like, yeah, so how many cars a day are you going to build? So how long is it going to take? Okay, it's no longer a couple of years.
The day has 24 hours.
Yeah, I know.
You can split it in three.
And I know how many you like to sleep. So
you only work half time?
Yeah.
12 hours a day?
Yeah.
So. And it's funny because it's everything I can't control is what I'm like drawing the line. If I can do it, I'm all for it. But if I can't, it's like, okay, no. Because I'm not going to be pushing you or.
Right. Well, to recognize the things that can't be controlled so well and figure out how to deal with that.
So we tell them, we can have our house already and then you can build more.
Mm-hmm.
Plenty of years ahead of you, too.
Sure.
I want to see what his truck
looks
like. Yeah, it's good. Source there is. It's full of nutrients. Well, the point is collecting.
So will this fill a bed, Liam?
Fill a bed.
He puts that in with the compost, right?
I'd break it up and put it in the barrel.
And you pee on
it. Pee
in the barrel. So much better. You have like a, and then you get the water out, you get the liquid out, you kind of mix it in, and you get the liquid that's black, and then you mix that 1 to 10. That's a good fertilizer in your garden. Just 1 to 10, you mix it out in your garden.
What was 1 to 10 what?
1 to 10 is, you get that black liquid.
Water to
pee. It's got lots of potassium and lots of nitrogen in it.
Okay, I have bought biochar in the bag from the stores. I've never tried to make it or ever even, watch somebody make it. So how is this different than what
there's all sorts of different ways of making charcoal, for sure. Charcoal is really old thing. In Europe, all the forests. They still make charcoal in Ethiopia. They're bringing all their upper forests in charcoal.
South America, they're ripping.
But,
getting rid of the forests.
There's all sorts of different ways. Most of it's having it in the kiln, but you can't really have it brush in the kiln.
Can't have what in the kiln?
Brush.
Oh.
Brush. And usually you're doing the older pieces that are like, longer than 10 years old. So you're not using ramual wood, which is really carbon that was taken out of the atmosphere from a year ago or 2 years ago. You're using really old wood. There are biochar, they're starting to make biochar, I think they have some contracts in the West. And when the company gets big enough, they have to keep going. And they had no feedstock, so they started to actually cut down forests to make their biochar. So they're kind of other. But if you're doing it around the house, around the farm, you use a lot of charcoal. And this charcoal, where you pee and stuff like that, you won't have any smells or anything.
No filter at all.
How long do you soak it? Well, I don't
I do whenever it's convenient.
Well, I didn't say that.
Yeah.
So, like, do you soak it?
I have to do things when I can.
But do you soak it for a month, a week?
Sometimes it's all winter. Yeah, sometimes it's in 2 days.
Mm. In 2 days, we'll charge it up with the nitrogen?
Yeah, we think so. You know, you just get into the charcoal and you just saturate it.
And you're soaking it in the barrel, huh?
Yeah, yeah. Totally plastic. Submersed.
It's a plastic
anaerobic barrel. Yeah. Uh-huh. And then you get the sludge on the bottom, and I have Whippoorwill on the over there. He's drying it, and he's trying to make some fireworks out of it. Because, you know, it's got, you know, what is it, saltpeter, or is that sulfur in there?
The Whippoorwill
is trying to make... Well,
he... Say that again.
There's a fella named Whippoorwill, and he's trying to make fireworks and stuff, and you know, something explosive. We actually went online, and he's actually from Washington, D.C., and he was a security guy on the web, and we were looking online for how to make... That is not a good thing. He said that will be in the NSA's books for a long time.
Yeah.
They're not going to throw that one away.
Off the grid. In the mountains and North Carolina.
Okay. Making explosives.
See all that black stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Ideally, I'd have some of the brain.
That's for me. That's for me.
I'm considering some brush piles I have right now. There's no water, so it's good.
Oh! He's got houses everywhere.
You have a creek or something?
Not close enough.
You sure if I got water over there,
buddy? Yeah, you got that water.
300-gallon tank. I guess you have a front-end loader.
Well, I have from Harbor Freight a little two-horsepower pump.
Yeah.
1-inch utility pump. And I just dip it right into the water supply and turn it on, and it can run full blast, and it's just like having a normal hose. It's really quite inexpensive. And I get it that
Are these like little hand pumps? Well,
there was
an
old
one that just
came out today.
A little,
I have a tank behind. My spring comes to... Yeah.